Hey, what's good, y'all? Fuzion here, back on the video. Today I do want to do a quick reaction to the Stephen A. Smith and the Patrick Beverley debate on Chris Paul's legacy and his defensive ability. I'm going to be dropping another reaction later on today, as well as a new series coming out as well. Just talking about the different matchups that we did have earlier in like the playoffs. I'm going to be talking about the Suns versus like the Pelicans first, and I will be talking about that, and that should be dropping about 4 o'clock. So definitely make sure that you got the post notifications on, as well as you are subscribed, so you don't miss it. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm actually running back a little bit. I was making sure that the sound was good. As he should. Point God. Yeah, so let's go ahead and talk about this real quick. Patrick Beverley, he is a premier defender, top five defender in the league. And I believe later on in the video, he's going to talk about his like defensive stats. Just a spoiler alert, he is technically on paper a better like defender as far as like percentages than Giannis. And we all know that Giannis is a god defender himself. In his own right, so he has a lot of I guess the right word is like clout. We don't know a word I was trying to say. So he knows what he's talking about. He has that tenure and proof of him being a premier like defender. So he knows who he has to be more prepared for and who he really doesn't have to be. Chris Paul, as a player, he is a future Hall of Famer. For sure, top 10 point guard, arguably top 5 point guard ever. He knows how to put his team in the right position. He is a floor general. He knows how to lead a team like to win. But he leads the team differently than a Steph Curry. Steph Curry is going to give you 50. He'll be raining threes, and you hope that he does not get hot or start to do his little shimmy. Because that means he's going to start raining. And not just him, Clay's going to start hitting. And not just him, Poole is going to start hitting. And he's going to run you around the floor until you're exhausted, you can't do anything, and he's gonna shoot. That's what he does. He takes over the game by ball movement, off ball movement, back screen, back cuts, front cuts, obviously shooting, causing him like to be double teamed, and then making that extra pass to another sniper with Klay Thompson. Another sniper with Paul with Jordan Poole. He'll get the ball to Draymond, and then Draymond will handle it from there. That is what Steph Curry will do to you. So you have to be on your P's and Q's with him. Chris Paul isn't a scorer. He is going to win the game himself by putting his team in the right position. Now, don't get me wrong, he did have 30-point games this year. And he can score the basketball, but that's not his like primary way of winning like basketball. Devin Booker is supposed to be that guy. And if he's not hitting, Chris Paul may do it himself, but he knows how to get his team in the right position. And I think that this the Suns team is lacking a second shot like creator, someone who can take you off at the dribble and score, like a Jordan Clarkson or a Eric Gordon, or even if they got a Jamal Crawford, I think that would have been perfect for them, because that's what they're missing. DeAndre Ayton is dog shit useless. He's not doing it. He sucks. So he's not even a good third option. Like, the only reason he's getting his points is because Chris Paul knows how to put him in the right position to have him score those easy tip backs, the pick and rolls, and those type of scoring. But without that, we'll get him out of here. He ain't doing nothing. So what Patrick Beverley says makes sense on paper. It makes sense through the eye test. It just makes sense. So, guys, let's keep going. Yep. And before we do get to what he is just about to say, I agree. Chris Paul knows how to fit like the rules to pretty much make him look better. Now, don't get me wrong, he's a point guard, but he knows how to get on your nerves. He's a great irritant, as well as he knows how to bend the rules to fit him. Just like how James Harden does it. He knows how to get the rip through calls. He knows how to foul without being called for the foul. Now, if that was any other player like a Patrick Beverley, who really isn't a fair comparison because of his reputation, but if that was any like a Cameron Payne on the same team, I believe he would get those fouls. I believe that he would have fouled out if Cameron Payne did the exact same stuff that Chris Paul does. But that's just how it is in sports, just in general. Why would you want a big name player who is on the court, who people come to watch and see, who pay to come and see, who gets on like TV to see what is Chris Paul going to do? Why are you going to let him foul out? That doesn't make sense as a like business like perspective. So it makes sense looking at it that way. But on the flip side, he would have fouled out, you know? He would have been gone, because he does use the rules to his advantage, and they don't call it equal like for everybody. But he has earned that because he's playing God. So, you know, comment below what you guys think about that. Because, you know, I have mixed messages about it, because or LeBron does the same thing. Giannis does the same thing. But I believe that they earn that because they're just better than everybody. But hey, you know. Tell me what you guys think. And I do want to talk about this point he just made also. Chris Paul is older. He's slower. He's 6 foot. He's not as explosive, but I don't think he's ever been a solid like defender as it is. I mean, he has quick hands, but that really doesn't equal good quality like defender. So a lot of people attack him just like they attack Steph Curry. So, I think that this is valid. Now, I do want to let you guys know that I did watch this before because I did do a, try to do a take one right before this, but then, well, the video got corrupted, so, yeah. But anyway, yeah, so that's why I somewhat know what they're going to be talking about, but I just don't understand as far as when did Chris Paul become this lockdown like defender when he has never been that. That has never been his role. He has always been the floor general. But that's pretty much all that I really got to say about this point. So let's keep going here. I don't think he deserves the Ben Simmons slander because, well, Ben Simmons just didn't play. And now he's saying the back injury, but he ain't played like the whole year. And then people have been saying it's had to do with his mental health and all this and all that, which I understand, but where did the back injury come from? And I don't even be starting on Ben Simmons, but let's keep going. God, I hate that guy. I hate Ben Simmons, man. Thank you. I'm going to skip this because he does talk about how great of a defender he is and all this and all that. So we already know he's a great defender. So let's keep going. Oh, wait, this is a great point here. Hold on. Which is a great like stat to show how great of a defender he is. Giannis is 6'11" with a 7'5" wingspan. Obviously, I am exaggerating, but Pat Bev, he's 6 foot, maybe with a 6'6" wingspan, maybe. That's a great stat to show how good of a like defender Patrick Beverley is. He is someone who can guard. Now he may get scored on, but he'll make it really, really hard for you to score like that bucket. And I don't know about you guys, if you have ever played basketball at the park or like the gym and you have to play against someone who is a great like defender, scoring on that guy is hard. And if you do score, you had to use almost everything in your bag of tricks. So you feel exhausted after scoring that one button. So hey, you know, I think that's a great stat that he did point out. He's a fool. I don't think, and sorry for me like pausing again, but I don't think, so I already know where he's like going with this already, but I don't think that Patrick Beverley is trying to compare Chris Paul's like defensive prowess like to his, because that's not fair. Pat Bev just threw out like the stat that shows he is top two like defender in the league. So there's no way that Chris Paul can really be like compared to that, because, you know, Chris Paul isn't known to be a defender. But I don't think that's what he's doing, so we'll continue and then he'll explain it some more. When he said this the first time, when I did watch it, I think that was one of the most like profound things that he has said. Because John Stockton and Chris Paul play the exact same way. John Stockton is a pass-first point guard. Gets his team involved. He's not as much of a shooter or a scorer as Chris Paul, but I think he could have done that. But he made sure to get Karl Malone involved because he knows that that's the mailman. He gonna deliver. But hey, I just, you know, John Stockton plays defense. He plays both sides of the ball. Chris Paul plays offense quite well. He lacks on like the defensive side because he always, well, because it's like a much different league now. But even when he was younger, I felt like he played good enough defense to where it looked like he played quality defense compared to like the rest of like the league. So, but hey, I don't know, man. That's a good point. Yeah, John Stockton would have locked up. All right, yeah, that's pretty much everything. Thanks for watching. Leave a comment down below as well. Part two is going to be dropping later on today as well. And just like I said earlier, I'm starting a new series that's going to be dropping at 4 p.m. today. So make sure that you got the comments. I mean, that you're subscribed as well as the post notifications on. And I'll see you guys later. Peace.